Welcome back. In this session, we are going to test release strategy configuration. So first step is to create a purchase requisition. See, this purchase requisition creation is not mandatory. Even you want, you can go directly from here. So we'll create this from here. Testing. This is PR. PO. Value is less than 100. So this is our first testing. I will take other information. This is material number. So I will take this material, copy this for testing purpose. This is material. Here we have vendors. This is vendor. So now copy this, go to ME51N. Enter your article number here, enter quantity 1. Check for consistency. We don't have any issues here. Storage location 3001. Save this. We have successfully created purchase requisition. Copy this. Paste here. This is the purchase requisition. Next step is to create a purchase order. Unless and until PO is approved, we cannot print and we cannot transmit this PO to vendor. That is the use of this release strategy. ME21N. Click on this one. Purchase requisition. What is the PR number? 6363. This one. Select this. Enter a vendor. Take any vendor from here. Press enter. See if everything is okay. Once you click on this, this check system will add one more tab here. If everything is okay, NB document, this criteria is satisfied. Purchasing organization 8800, company code 8800, plant is 8801. So this criteria is satisfied. The value of this one, you can see print preview. What is the value? Value is 10. So now check this. Right now we don't have any tab here. We are getting a new tab here. Who is the concerned person? If value is less than 100, supply chain manager. Save this. We have successfully created first purchase order. Copy this number. Now, before releasing, we will go to MIGO, then we will see whether it is working or not. MIGO, goods receipt. I want to receive goods against this PO. What is the message we are getting here? Purchasing document not yet released. To release this purchasing document, go to ME29N. Here, change this. Copy this. Press enter. See here, this is the place you can release. This is release, release affected with the release code. If you want to cancel this release, you can cancel. Released. Save this. Now go to MIGO, goods receipt. This is my PO, recent PO. Press enter. See, we are not getting that message because PO is released. Even you can go and check from ME23N, enter here, press enter. See, this is released. Now check here, post this. See, we have successfully posted this MIGO goods receipt. If you want to complete MIRO, go to MIRO, invoice verification. Enter purchase order here. Select this one, V0. Now just ensure here what is the code. Change this to V0. Simulate. We need to enter the value here, this value. Then simulate again, post this. See, document posted. If you want to see this document, you can display the same file. This is the document posted. Hope you understand. I am going to simulate other two scenarios as well, but this time I am not going to create a purchase requisition. I want to start directly from here. Quickly, I want to test other two scenarios as well. These scenarios, if values between and values above 500. We have successfully tested this one. Now go to ME21N. This time I am going to test directly from ME21N. I am not going to create any purchase requisition. This is only simulation. Whether release strategy created by us is working properly or not. I want to see that. This NB, press enter. Enter material number. Now enter here 10 quantity. Enter here 1 quantity. Check this. See, it is working. Enter here 11 quantity. Check this, it is working because value is above 100 here. See, what is the value? Value is 110. Now, if the value is 51, check this, this is working. What is the value now? Value is above 500. Here, what I want to test. The process is designed like this. Value is less than 100. Value between 101 to 500. Under this one, we are covering up to 99 only. We are not going to cover this 100. Actually, less than is wrong here. This should be less than or equal. That I will show you practically. See, if I enter 10 quantity, price of this is 10. check this. This got disappeared. This tab is disappeared. What is the value here? 100. If the value is exactly 100, it is not working. You need to take care of these kind of the issues. So price is 10 means 500. I want to test this. If I enter 50 quantity, it is not going to work. See, we are not getting any additional tab. If I enter 51, it is working fine. So you need to take care of these kind of the issues. Why we are getting like this? This is the issue. For this one, we are covering up to 99. Under this group, we are covering from 101. So 100 is missing. Here up to 499. We covered up to 499. Here above 501. So 500 is missing. So if you come across any value 100, 500, then it is not going to work. So what we have to do? We change this to less than or equal 100. This is also same case. We'll go in quickly. We are going to change this. Go to configuration. Material management. Purchase order. This is characteristics. So what is the characteristics for value? Copy this. Go to change mode. This is already in change. Go to values. Here we enter like this. So what we will do, we'll change this. Press F1. See, this we are going to consider this one. Less than or equal. Copy this. Here I will enter 100. So here we are covering up to 100. So this is also we should change. Press F1. Here we are going to increase this value to 501 so that I can cover up to 500 here. Save this. Go back, edit class, check release strategy. Click on this one. Click on this. Select first group. Go to classification. See, you need to select this one. Back. Save this. For second one, this is up to 501. Go to classification. F4. This select this one, 501. Okay, go back, save this. There is no change in third one. Here we don't have any changes. This is as it is. Now go to purchase order, ME21N. Press enter. If you enter quantity 10, in previous case we are not getting a tab here. Check this. See, we are getting a tab here. If the value is 100, print preview. So what is the value? 100. So enter 50 here. Click on this one. Click on check. See, it is working. The value is 51. It is working fine. save this. Note down this number. If you want to release purchase orders in mass, there is a T code. See, this is ME29N is for individual. This is ME28 is collective. Go to ME28. Here enter A1. Here select best ALV. Execute this. See, here we have this PO 501. Click on release possible. Go back. Enter A2. See, we are releasing business unit head. This is the second person releasing. Release this. Go back. Now check PO ME23N. Enter. Release strategy. See, this is released by 2%. If finance manager releases this PO, then next steps are possible. Sending this to vendor and MIGO, other process is possible. Hope you understand.